Good morning, everyone. How are you all?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
How are you? Good. What about you all?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Very good morning.
How are you, ma'am?
I'm fine, Suhana. Thank you very much. Okay. I hope everybody's ready with their literature textbook part two.
Yes.
Okay. In the previous session, we have learned the meanings of selected very important words from lesson number 10, finding the man cub, right?
Yes.
I had sent the notes to you. Have you been able to check, write and learn the meanings?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Keep your devices muted. I'm going to make sure that you have understood and remember the meanings. Okay, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Rida, unmute your device and tell me the meaning of squealing. Squealing. Yes, very good. One more question for you. Who were squealing? As per the story, who were squealing?
Mother wolves for cubs.
Yes, very good. The four cubs of mother wolf were squealing. Thank you, Rida. Anamika, meaning of mischief?
Making trouble.
Making trouble. Who was doing mischief?
Jackal.
Jackal. Yes. Very good. Okay. Then Rashid. Meaning of leftovers.
Food that is left unfinished.
Fantastic. Who feasted on the leftovers?
The Sher Khan.
Sher Khan feasted on leftovers? No way.
The jackal.
Yes, very good. The jackal feasted on the leftovers. Okay. Thank you, Roshan. Then Suhana. Meaning of prey?
An animal.
Hunted.
Hunted for food.
Yes, very good. An animal hunted for food is called jackal. Can you tell me the name for the animal that hunts? What is it called? Animal that is hunted is called prey. What is the animal which hunts called?
Jackal.
No.
Predator.
Yes, yes, you're right. The animal which hunts is called the predator, and the animal that is hunted is called the prey. Try to remember the meanings of both these words, all of you, okay? Yeah, difference is there. Thank you, Suhana. Rex, meaning of rustled.
Rustled.
Rustled. The bushes rustled. The bushes rustled. Rustled means? Rex doesn't know. Okay, Nora.
Make a soft cracking sound.
Rustled. E-D. E-D are the letters at the end. So which tense form?
Soft cry. Soft sound.
Anna Mary, wait. Please wait. Yes, Nora. Made. Not make. Rustled is in the past tense form, right? So the meaning also must be given in the past tense form. What is the past tense of make? You use the word make, right?
Made.
Yes. Please repeat the meaning.
Made a soft cracking sound.
Fantastic. Yes. Made a soft crackling sound. Very good, Nora. I hope it is clear to everybody.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, Anna Mary, unmute.
Ma'am.
Anna Mary.
Ma'am.
Yeah. Meaning of thrust. Thrust.
Thrust.
Sher Khan thrust his huge head and shoulders into the cave. Thrust.
Push the
To push with force. To push with force. Okay, very good. To push with force. To push with force. Okay. I hope everybody is clear with the meanings of selected words that we have learned.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will continue with the discussion of other words. I want everybody to be ready with their rough notebook. Rough notebook. We will be discussing and writing in the rough notebook now. And later on, I want you to copy it down neatly into the literature notebook. I will be sharing the notes also. Anunaya, unmute your device and tell me the antonym of carefully. Question number two, antonyms. Okay, before you tell me the antonym, why don't you tell me the meaning of the word antonyms? What do you understand by antonyms?
Opposites.
Antonyms are opposites or words that have completely different meanings. Okay, now the word for you is carefully. Carefully. What is the antonym or opposite of carefully?
Carefully.
Carefully means someone or something that is very careful about what all he or she does. So the antonym or opposite will be someone or something that is not at all careful about what he or she is doing.
Danger.
No. Carefully. So without care when we do something, what is the word?
Ma'am?
Yes, Niharika.
Careless.
Careless, yes. But the word here is carefully. So what will be the antonym?
Carelessly.
Careful.
The prefix li is there. The suffix li is there. With careful, the suffix li is added. So?
I'm careful.
No, the suffix li is there, li.
Carelessly.
Yes, very good. So see, we have learnt about prefixes and suffixes, right? So when you notice a suffix or prefix with the word that is given, you must, if needed, you must try to add it with the antonym or meaning also, okay? Carelessly. Carelessly. Carefully. The antonym is carelessly. Is it clear to everybody? Yeah. Try to avoid speaking in between. It disturbs everybody, okay? Adnan. The next word is forward. 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 What is the antonym of forward? Forward means to move ahead, ahead, in front. So what will be the antonym or opposite? Yes, Adnan.
Rewind.
Sorry?
Rewind.
No, rewind. No. About movement. To move in front is called forward. So to move behind, what will be? To move behind.
What will
be? Yes, very good. The antonym of forward is backward. backward. We are using these words in terms of the concept in the story. Okay, that's where we need to understand these words. Thank you, Adnan. Krishna Raj, tell me the antonym of vanish. V-A-N-I-S-H. First, you tell me the meaning of vanish. What do you understand by vanish? Krishna Raj, what is the meaning of vanish? Jackal vanished into the darkness of the night. Vanish means?
Disappeared.
Disappear. So what is the antonym of vanish?
Disappeared.
Disappear. The meaning of vanish is disappear. So what is the antonym or opposite of disappear? What is the antonym of disappear or vanish?
Appeared.
Appear. Yes. Appear. Appear. ED is not needed. Appear. That is enough. Because this word vanish is also in the present form, vanish. If it was vanished, we could have written the antonym as appeared. But here the word is only vanish. So the antonym will be appear. See, when you are not able to get the direct antonym of a particular word, try to remember its meaning. Then it will be easier to get its antonym. Okay, thank you, Rishit. Krishna Raj, did you understand now? Antonym of vanishes?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the antonym of vanish? Tell me the antonym of vanish. Appear. Appear.
Appear.
Okay. Aiden Rojo, tell me the antonym of close by. C-L-O-S-E. Close by. Close by means nearby. Nearby. Aiden Rojo, what is the antonym or opposite of close by? Close by means nearby. So what is the antonym? Opposite of close is? Opposite of near is?
Far.
Far, yes. So the antonym of close by is far away. Far away. Understood? Aiden Rojo?
Yes,
repeat,
ma'am.
Repeat. What is the antonym of close by?
Far away.
Far away. Yes. Antonym or opposite of close by is far away. Okay. Thank you. Now, in the next equation, we are going to discuss the past tense forms of certain words. Past tense, T-E-N-S-E. Past tense forms. Number one, slide, S-L-I-D-E, Rex. What is the past tense of slide? S-L-I-D-E, slide, past tense.
Slided.
Past tense.
Past tense.
You cannot add ed and make the past tense of any word. That is not allowed. Heaven, where is your book? Sit properly. Sit properly. The past tense of slide is?
Slid.
Yes. S-L-I-D. Slid. The past tense of slide is? Slid. Okay. Heaven, tell me the past tense of wake. W-A-K-E, wake. Father Wolf. The past tense of wake is used there.
Woke.
Woke, yes. Spelling? W-O-K-E, woke. Okay, good. Aiden, past tense of shine? S-H-I-N-E, shine. Past tense?
Shine.
Spelling?
S-H.
Aiden Dias, give me the answer. Past tense of shine.
S-H-I-N-E.
Past tense is? Shown. S-H-O-N-E. What shone into the cave? Aiden Dias, what shone into the cave? The moon shone into the cave. The moon shone into the cave. Do you remember? Okay, those who read the lesson only will be able to remember and understand all these things. I ask you in every class, I ask you to read, right? Those who do that will be able to understand as well as remember everything properly. This is a very simple lesson. Okay, Zishan. Next word is catch. Catch. What is the past tense of catch?
Yes, ma'am.
Past tense of catch.
Catch.
C-A-T-C-H. Catch. Past tense.
Caught.
Yes, Zishan.
Catched.
Now, anybody else wishes to try?
Caught.
Caught, yes. Caught. Yes, Zishan. Who gave the answer? Yes, he's right. C-A-U-G-H-T, caught. The past tense of catch is caught. C-A-U-G-H-T, caught. Okay. Now, let us move to the next question, that is comprehension. 2, 4, 6. The fourth one, reading comprehension. First one. Avantika, read question number 1 and tell me the answer. Page number 16.
What did Father Wolf do after he woke up?
Yes. I want the answers in complete sentences only. Keep that in mind.
Father Wolf yawned.
Father Wolf.
Father Wolf yawned.
It's not yawned. Yawned. W is there, right? Yawned.
Yawned.
Yes.
Scratched
himself. Scratched himself.
Scratched himself.
Spread
out his paw.
After
he woke up.
Yes, you're right. Very good. Father Wolf yawned. Y-A-W-N-E-D. Yawned. Scratched. S-C-R-A-T-C-H-E-D. Scratched himself. Father Wolf yawned, scratched himself, and spread, S-P-R-E-A-D, spread out, 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 his, his, his paws, 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 after, after, he, woke, 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 up, up, after he woke up. Father Wolf yawned, scratched himself, and spread out his paws after he woke up.
Okay,
now it's okay. I know what you were trying to say. Father Wolf yawned, scratched himself, and spread out his paws after he woke up. That's a very simple answer, right? We have revised this, wised and revised it multiple times. Arfin, please unmute your device and read question number two.
Why did no one like the jungle?
Jackal. Why did no one like the jackal?
No one like him.
Like? In the answer, which tense?
Past tense.
So what is the word?
No one liked him.
No one liked whom?
Jackal.
Yes.
Because.
Because he
asked to tell.
Because he used. Because
he used to tell tales and make mischief.
Yes, very good. No one liked Jackal because he used to tell tales. T-A-L-E-S. Tales and A-N-D and make. M-A-K-E, make mischief, M-I-S-C-H-I-E-F, mischief. Okay, thank you, Arfin, good effort. No one liked Jackal because he used to tell tales, tales means stories, and make mischief. No one liked Jackal because he used to tell tales and make mischief. Okay, very good. Zeeshan, sit properly. Rissa, read question number three.
What was the law of jungle?
What was the law of the jungle? Tell me the answer. What was the law of the jungle?
The law of the jungle is that he...
No, what was? The law of the jungle?
The law of the jungle cannot change his...
No. In the question, the word used is was. So, you must use the word was in the answer as well. The law of the jungle was that. Yes, Risa, continue. The law of the jungle was that.
Yes. He can. Change his hunting area
Without
warning.
Yes, very good. Only was is the word that you went wrong with. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Because in the question, the word used is was. So accordingly, we must write the answers. The law of the jungle was that. See, it is that law was applicable to all the animals, right? So we will use the word one. One means any particular animal. One means any particular animal of the forest. The law of the jungle was that one cannot. Was that one cannot. C-H-A-N-G-E. Change. His hunting. H-U-N-T-I-N-G. Hunting. One cannot change his hunting
not finished.
Hunting area. Hunting area without. W-I-T-H-O-U-T. Without warning. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. Who's calling?
Can you show me the second question?
Second question. Okay, I will try. Are you able to see now?
Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. The law of the jungle was that one cannot change his hunting area without warning. Okay. Thank you, Riza. Abel Rinson, unmute your device and read question number 4. Question number 4. Unmute your device. Read question number 4 on page number 16. Textbook, page number 16. Abel Rinson, please read question number 4.
Ma'am?
Hmm.
The?
Yes.
For?
Who? W-H-O. Who? S-P-O-K-E. Spoke.
Spoke.
Hmm. Who spoke?
Who spoke?
Mm. Continue reading. To? Who spoke to?
Who spoke to?
Mm. S-H-E-R-E. Share. K-H-A-N. Khan. Share Khan.
Share Khan.
What is the next word? W-I-T-H. Rex, sit properly. With?
With?
Mm. G-R-E-A-T. Great?
Great.
Mm. A-N-G-E-R. Anger?
Anger.
Mm. In the end?
In the end.
Mm. Who spoke with, who spoke to Shere Khan with great anger? In the end of the story, who spoke to Shere Khan with great anger? Great anger means with a lot of anger.
Mother Wolf.
Yes. Rex, am I asking you the question? No. Then let Abel Rinson answer. Sorry?
Mother wolf.
Mother wolf. Yes, you are right. Give me the answer in a complete sentence, Abel. Who spoke to... Resume your device, please. Who spoke to Sher Khan with great anger in the end? So say the answer in a complete sentence. Mother wolf.
Mother wolf.
Hmm. Spoke to whom?
Sher Khan.
Mother wolf spoke to Sher Khan.
Mother wolf.
Hmm. Spoke to Sher Khan.
Spoke to Sher Khan.
Hmm.
Mother wolf.
Spoke to Sher Khan. With.
Spoke to Sher Khan.
Hmm. With great anger.
With great anger.
Hmm. Great anger means a lot of anger in her voice. With great anger. Mother wolf spoke to Sher Khan with great anger. Mother wolf spoke to Sher Khan with great anger.
Mother wolf
spoke to Sher Khan.
Spoke to Sher Khan
with great anger.
With great anger.
Yes. Okay, Abel. Thank you. Anunaya, read the first value-based question.
What, ma'am?
Please read the first value-based question.
Okay, ma'am.
Value-based question on the same page, 16. Value-based question.
Value-based.
Below these questions which we did now. Exercise 3, value-based questions, page number 16.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, read. Why do you think
the baby was not scared?
The baby was not scared.
Scared of the wolves.
Of the wolves, yeah.
Wolves.
Anunaya, why do you think that the baby was not scared? We all know that the baby, when he saw the wolves, he looked at Father Wolf and he laughed. That means he was not scared. What was the reason? What was the reason? Who had saved the baby from Sher Khan? Who saved the baby from Sher Khan?
Because the baby was small, so he don't know that the wolf, it was a wolf.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else wishes to try? Try to speak in your own words.
Krishnaraj.
Sorry?
Krishnaraj.
Yeah, try Krishnaraj.
Mother wolf saved him. And brought him to the cave.
Father wolf.
Yeah.
Father wolf brought the baby to the cave, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So he was not scared.
Yeah.
Is that what you want to say, Krishnaraj?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, you're right. You're right. You're right. And apart from that, the baby did not know that wolves are dangerous animals. Okay. The first reason is that Father Wolf saved the baby from Sher Khan. And then the next reason is that the baby was not aware, did not know that wolves are dangerous animals. And that is the reason the baby was not scared of the wolves. Okay, clear? Okay, the next one, Nora, try. What do you think of Sher Khan? Did he care for the other animals? What do you think of Sher Khan? Did he care about the other animals?
No.
What kind of animal was Sher Khan?
Sher Khan was a tiger.
Was a tiger. Cruel animal. Cruel animal.
Cruel animal.
Yeah. Did he care about the other animals?
No.
No. What makes you say that? He did something that makes us feel that he didn't care about the other animals. What was that? Did he follow something? He didn't follow something. Something very important for the jungle.
Follow his prey.
Follow the law of the jungle.
Law of the jungle.
What was the law of the jungle?
One animal cannot change his hunting area without warning.
Sher Khan did that, right?
Yes.
That means he did not follow the law of the jungle. That shows he did not care about the other animals. If he had cared for the other animals, he would never have done that. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So good. It was a good session with you all. All of you have tried your best to answer the questions. Very good. Keep the corrections in mind. And I'll be sending the notes to you in the group. Please copy them down neatly into your literature notebook. Okay? Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you in the next class.
Thank you. Bye-bye.